Hello, it's Eric Lawler from Joe.ie. We're on the rooftop of Stephen's Green Shopping Centre for the Carlsberg Join the Legends series, and I'm joined by the unmistakable, the immensely talented, the legend, that is, Mr. Robbie Fowler. Robbie, how are you?
How are you, okay?
Great to have you here, and you're over in Dublin. Great stuff for being hit by balls from all over, obviously Manchester United fans. You're over in Dublin. Have you been? Do you come up to Dublin much?
I've been over a few times, but you can obviously Liverpool done it over the road, isn't it, really? So, yeah, come over. I mean, I've come over with Jason McAteer a few times as well. He's the self-proclaimed David Beckham of Ireland, so, he's dragged us over a few times.
He is, and I can't talk to you without asking you about Liverpool, and they're having a magnificent season this season. And do you think the title is probably just a bit out of reach, or do you think they'll challenge to the end and top four is very attainable?
Well, you know what, they will challenge to the end. It's not out of reach, but you know, being a Liverpool ex-player, you know, I think we're brought up on, you know, taking each game as it comes. I know it's cliched answers and probably not the ones everyone to hear, but they're certainly in with a chance. You know, they're on merit. They've not been lucky in any way. You know, they've been great to watch, I think, if we're being honest. And I don't think anyone would have any qualms, you know, with Liverpool winning it, because you know, they have been so good this year. But you know, there's a few other teams who will try and stop them. You know, i.e., you know, Arsenal, Chelsea, and City. But look, you know, Liverpool are going great guns at the minute, and you know, long may continue.
Big match on Sunday, Old Trafford, Manchester United, who've had better seasons, let's be honest. And would you, I mean, all the forum books would point to a fairly comfortable Liverpool win. Would you be of the same opinion? And do you think David Moyes is the man for Manchester United?
You know what? No, I don't think, you know, it will be a comfortable win. I think it'll be a very, very hard game. Look, you know, let's not be honest. Well, let's be honest here. Manchester United, you know, walked away with the Premier League last year, and there's obviously two players been added to that who are both excellent players, so it will be a tough game. excuse me. And obviously Liverpool, I think they will be favourites, but I think you know, the fact is that the games over the years, it's always been sort of Man United, you know, challenging for the league, and Liverpool trying to stop them, and now it's a case of you know, the other way round. So it'll be interesting to see how the game pans out and how it develops. But you know, I fully expect it to be tight, and you know, I mean, you say like the Everton Liverpool games,
four goes out the window.
And yeah, I think that's to a certain extent happening now with the Liverpool Man United games. And I mean, I think it's obvious who I want to win. And
no way, Robbie Hill.
Yeah, no, honestly. But look, obviously David Moyes going into Manchester United, it was always going to be a difficult job after Sir Alex. And I think what he's achieved in the game has been nothing short of phenomenal. And you know, obviously he's felt David Moyes is the right man. And look, he's only been there a short space of time, not had the greatest starts, but look, he's not a bad manager, is he? You know, he is a good manager, and I think his record, you know, at Everton will tell you that. You know, who's maybe got Everton above the positions where, you know, where many people have seen them for
punching above their weight, kind of thing.
For many, many years. So look, he's not a bad manager, and he will get things right, you know, I'm sure, at Manchester United. And but you know, to be honest, you know, I'm not really bothered. You know? but you know, obviously, I want Liverpool to do well, and you know, I don't really worry about others, and you know, I want Liverpool to win everything, and that's you know, where my priorities will lie for a long, long time.
Can't say fairer than that, Robbie. And before we let you go, Robbie, is there a moment in your career as a Liverpool player which was the highlight of your Liverpool career?
You know what, this is, I mean, I get asked this a lot of times.
Oh, sorry, Robbie, I'll try and think of an original question.
To be honest, it's a good question, because, I mean, the answer is brilliant, because, I mean, I was unlucky, if you like, to leave Liverpool. You know, I've been, you know, won trophies, I've played for Liverpool in hundreds of games, I've scored, you know, many, many goals, but by far the best experience for me with Liverpool was re-signing. You know, obviously leaving, yeah, it's not ideal. You don't want it to happen, but it gave me the chance to re-sign, which was doubly special.
Yeah, so you felt like you got a second chance to join in the boyhood club.
It was brilliant, and you know, I'm not just saying this because, you know, it's like a feel-good factor for me, or you know, it's the correct answer because everyone to hear. You know, I really, really mean that.
Yeah, I can see it in your eyes, Robbie. You mean it from the bottom of your heart. But sorry, right then, if I can't get you to get a favourite match, is there a favourite goal you have?
Well, yeah, there's a few actually. I think, look, you know, being a Liverpool lad, you know, scoring for Liverpool, I think any goal against against Everton, the special, and any goal against Manchester United. But if I had to sort of pick one favourite goal that stood out, it would have to be the third against Arsenal. You know, that capped off the hat-trick in 4.5 minutes. To this day, it's a Premier League record, and you know, I hope. Look, I want Luis Suarez and Daniel Sturridge to go on and score many, many goals. But please let me have this record. You know,
at least wait till 5 minutes.
Yeah, let me keep this one. Yeah.
Robbie Fowler, thanks very much for talking to us. Cheers, mate. Thanks a million.